guys. Thanks for tuning in and welcome to Laughs with Larry's Cooking with Comics. This month we thought we'd do something fun and special and give you the best of 19 episodes of cooking with some of the funniest comedians on this planet. So sit back, grab a drink, grab a snack, and enjoy.
Hey guys,
thanks for tuning in and welcome to Laughs with Larry's Cooking with Comics.
I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder.
All right, so a couple's been married for 40 years, right? And the spark's gone. And so it's their anniversary, and the lady decides, hey, time to turn. Ooh, you see
right,
how that
wow,
is?
Wow, that could cook really quick.
Yes, it is. So the lady decides she's gonna spice this thing up. She's going to at least give it one more shot.
Right.
So she goes to a lingerie shop, not Victoria's Secret. She goes to the sleazy place by the airport. You know what I'm talking about. And she goes in there and she gets her a really hot outfit and a lady's helping her. And she goes, hey, you ever tried crotchless panties? She goes, I never even heard of them. She goes, I'll try anything. So she puts on the whole outfit and the crotchless panties and she's laying on the couch and her husband comes in from golf and he walks in and she's laid out there, man, and she goes, hey, baby, you want some of this? He goes, hell no, look what it did to your underwear. All right.
A very funny guy told me a joke about ground beef.
Ooh.
A very funny man, he said, what's a cow with two legs?
I know this one, but I can't think of it.
Lean beef.
Yeah.
He was sort of a comedian.
I feel like I might know who told you that joke. Yeah.
Guy starts a business, 6 months later it takes off, right? So he hires a girl by the name of Mary, right? 6 months later, the business explodes. He hires a guy named Jack. 4 months after that, the business goes crazy and starts going downhill. He doesn't know what to do, lay Mary or Jack off.
Nice.
I thought it was cute.
That's cute. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's a bad reaction. There's a girl and she's really upset and she goes to her boyfriend's house and her boyfriend comes home from work and she starts crying and she says, I just got the worst news ever. I have to leave you. Everyone told me you're a pedophile. And he said, what? That is crazy. How does a 10-year-old even know what a pedophile is?
That's a good one.
Thank you. All the ones I know are dirty.
Do we have anyone in the house that has a joke? Maybe someone's a jokester.
There we go.
Two flies on a piece of shit.
Two pedophiles are sitting on a park bench when a 9-year-old girl walks by. And the first pedophile says, whoa, look at that. And the other pedophile says, yeah, she must have been something in her day.
What do you call two guys in a tutu parking cars?
Oh, no.
Oh, come on, please.
Huh. Ballet parking.
Yeah.
That joke has been on four shows.
Sometimes what I like to do when I'm cooking is I'll go out back and smoke a cigar while I just leave my baby on the floor.
That's good.
Yeah, and then my wife doesn't know because my wife is out, but then other times this, I gotta be around for it, so I can't do it. If I'm cooking salmon in the stove or the oven, what do you call it when you put it inside?
Bacon.
You call it bacon?
Bacon, you bake it in the oven.
Bacon salmon.
Baked salmon.
It's an oven.
It's an
oven.
So
what's the top of the oven? The stove?
Stove.
This is on the stove.
So I
put the fish in the oven, and then I'll go out and smoke, because I know I got 20 minutes, and then my wife won't know I smoke, because she'll come home and smell fish.
Smell fish.
And she goes, what's that? And then when she turns to look,
it's
then I
fish.
Club her over the head with a sock full of
you
coins.
You have a great relationship, I
see. It's wonderful.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
So you want to stir it. Sometimes what I do if I'm feeling naughty, Larry, if I'm feeling naughty, what I'll do is I'll drive to Atlantic City and cheat on my wife. But then other times...
But I guess we're having chicken?
We're having Southern fried chicken.
So I can put the bacon right back in
Tennessee,
your
store. Pat is from Tennessee, so I figured we'd give him a little Southern meal. He's been in New York so long, though, he's forgotten his drawl.
You know what? I never had one, Larry.
Okay, there you go.
You know why?
Why?
Parents never talked to me.
Did you know that Stevie Wonder challenged Tiger Woods to a golf match?
Yeah.
And Tiger Woods said, come on, you got to be kidding. Stevie said, no, good golfer. I have my friend stand there by the hole and he whistles and I aim at that. Tiger Woods says, all right, Stevie, I'll play golf again. Stevie says, well, let's play for a lot of money, make it interesting. Tiger Woods says, all right, name the time and the place. And Stevie Wonder says, how about tonight? You're wondering if I know it. The mother comes down and says to the daughter, what do you want for breakfast? She says, I guess I'll have some of those shitty cornflakes. So the father gets up and beats the hell out of the daughter. And the mother says to Johnny, what do you want for breakfast? He says, I sure don't want any of those fucking cornflakes.
A horse walks into a bar. Bartender says, what I want for eggs. The horse says, I've ate.
What?
Now, I'm going to tell you a secret. I wrote that.
You did?
Which one? A long time ago, I got this bright idea, like when we were starting a joke show, that I was going to do something where you add a line to a classic joke that's been around forever. Okay. And the oldest joke in the world is, a horse goes into a bar and the bartender says, why a long face? So I added the line, I have cancer. All right. And he just, I mean, did you?
No, I heard it. I didn't make it up. I heard it somewhere.
But I mean, I'm sure somebody else could have come up with the same premise, but I've never heard anybody say it before. There were only two jokes I could make it happen with. Why the long face? I have cancer. But they got to be so old. The jokes had to be so old that everybody knows the joke is over. Right. And the other one was, Mrs. Johnson, can Johnny come out and play baseball with us?
Oh, yes.
And she says, hey, you know Johnny has no arms legs. And no legs. And they say, that's all right, we're going to use him as third base. And his mother says, okay, I'll dress him in white. that was the extra line.
A lady breaks down, her car breaks down in San Francisco. So she brings the car to the mechanic. The mechanic says, listen, it's going to take me a while to figure it out. Why don't you go have lunch or whatever, you know? So she goes down to the pier or whatever. She has lunch. She comes back and she goes, so what's wrong with my car? He says, you blew a seal. She goes, no, it's just a little mayo from lunch.
That's terrible.
I thought it was cute.
You know the big fat...
I'm golfing over here.
The big fat Polish lady, pushes her car into the... The big fat Polish lady pushes her car into the gas station. And she says to the mechanic, she says, it conked out. So he works on it a little while. And pretty soon the engine's purring like a kitten. And she said, what's the story? He said, crap in the carburetor. She said, how long I have to do that?
Little. We're not doing well.
All right, I got it. I got it now.
Your sister's ass. Oh, I can't let you.
Come on.
Is that in the 50? Is that in the 50? How you doing, buddy?
Did you get a 50?
We're all counting on you, kiddo.
So, Regina, this is the name of the game, all right? The name of the game is Spoon in a Cup, all right?
Spoon in a Cup, all
right. Right, so you take the ball. The spoon is upside down. You have to balance.
Upside down?
No, I'm kidding. Oh, wait. I got to go back. Okay. Yeah, it is. I got two. Oh, shit, that flew off there.
Okay, so Karen, the object of this game is within a minute, we're going to see how many balls each one of us can get into the container. The one that has the most in the container at the end of the minute is the winner. I can't hold on to my balls.
God, it looks like my cup is full and yours is empty.
Okay.
You really are good.
Huh?
You're good.
I got a big nose. So, okay, Aaron, the purpose of this game, the feature of this game is actually with your hands behind your back.
The felch. Yeah.
Of this game is you're going to grab the bowl with the straw by a sucking motion.
Yeah.
And then you're going to run back here, touch the wall. And then you're gonna go back and put it in your mason jar, which is yours on the left.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go! Mm.
Oh, fuck. Uh-uh. Oh, yeah.
You gotta let it go?
Damn it!
Okay.
Okay, so put your wine down, and we're going to twerk these out. You got a minute to get those three boxes.
Oh, I got to twerk. Shut up. Are you kidding me?
What?
Where are we twerking?
Oh, anyway.
Are you serious? I'm going to twerk this out?
We're twerking all
over. Can we get, some song? Alexa, play Wheeler Walker Jr. What do I win?
You win a dinner. We'll take you to dinner right here at the Sparkling Martin Mansion.
There's no, you can't have a game without a real prize.
I'm out! My three balls are out! So who won that game?
You did.
All right, I did, okay. Hey, thank you very much.
Larry did.
I won out of all the games that we played on five shows, this is the first time I won.
So you win a copy of Jackie Martling's autobiography, The Joke Man, Bow to Stern.
Oh, thank you. I bought this, though.
Shut up.
Okay. Hey, wait. Huh? Hey. Wait a minute.
No, bro, you're fucking blowing my balls out of my fucking thing.
So, Kevin, the name of this game is Ping Pong Tic Tac Toe. So, what the object of the game is to bang one of these ping pong balls. You have the orange, I have the white. And we're going to bang it off the table, not like that, and try to get it into the cup. And whoever gets diagonally, straight in the line, or whatever, tic tac toe, you're the winner. Oh, I see Kevin. Oh, cheetah. Oh. Hell yeah. Oh. Oh.
Kevin! That's it! He did it!
Wait a minute! Time out!
In your face?
In my face! Hey, this ain't fucking working. Take the thing, put it on your
man.
Nose. Yeah, that's the better thing. Put a glob on. And then come over here.
Got it.
And knock it off, see? How you
what
doing?
What a game. I can see why this is popular the world over.
Growing up, and like had to have cereal, oatmeal. It's like there's certain breakfast foods, and that's it. You can't mess with that. You want pizza, whatever's gonna make you feel good, so then you leave the house.
Absolutely.
And you can be productive.
Absolutely. I used to have, when I was in the pest control business, I used to have White Castle 6 o'clock in the morning.
Oh my God. Oh,
honest to God.
Taking it to a new level.
Two, three. All right.
So I think we're ready to serve this.
So let's serve it.
Get a good amount of pork. So this is where these tofus come in.
Okay.
Plural. All right, so we just kind of flop these on top, like that.
Mm-hmm.
Take a little bit of these, clean hands.
Hey, man.
I like it. That's awesome to hear, man.
This is a home run.
Nice. I'm pumped.
This is such a home run.
That is so cool.
And it's
to hear.
So hot, but it's very good. Very hot.
So the midget goes to whorehouse. He takes off his pants. He has 2 foot thick.
Mm.
And the hooker says, "You're not putting that thing in me. I'll kiss it." He says, "Fuck you, I can do that myself."
What do a midget and a dwarf have in common?
What does a midget and a dwarf have in common?
Very little.
Chicken. How many? I need to know how many chickens are involved here. Did you go to like a farm? Here we are, going right into the oven here.
Ready?
Are you sure?
Yep, it's all ready.
We got 40 trays of chicken in the oven. Look at this.
This is my little sweet potato.
Dude.
The boss says to Juan,
Juan,
you know, Juan, I'm thinking that sex is like 50% play and 50% work. What do you think? Senor, I think that sex is 100% play. He says, Juan, why do you think that? He says, because if it was at all work, you would make me do it.
Look how fresh this tastes. I'm gonna take a bite.
Well, let me have a bite too, you cheap bastard.
Crispy.
I gotta tell you, I'd marry you for this.
Sweet.
This is fucking good.
Let's get out of here, baby. You got a lot of money. I need a sugar daddy. Let's go.
I'll buy you more McNuggets. Come on.
I need someone to pay my Walmart bill. Come on. Bing, beautiful. Look at that. You got the onion rings over there. Beautiful. All right,
wonderful.
These burgers are looking almost done. Let's see how the bread looks.
Oh, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to go see my cardiologist tomorrow.
Oh, we're going to be shitting blood till next Tuesday. But let me tell you something. It's going to be worth it. I want you to give me just a nickel's worth of that dressing in the middle.
What you want is a dollop.
A dollop.
Here's a dollop.
A dollop. It's definitely more than a dollop, but I'm not going to freak out. It's
I fine. Can take it off.
No, it's
I perfect. Give you half a dollop.
No, it's okay. It's perfect. Pickles. In. Pickles.
Wow.
In. Basil. So, boom, you got pickles on the bottom. You got the special sauce. Special sauce again.
How are you going to grab it?
And then you got, I'll show you. Then you got the minced onions right here, right? Bing, bang, boom. Now, let's get that other patty. Put that patty right here. There you go. Praise Allah.
Oh, my God. This is like...
Beautiful. Here
this is like a double decker.
Okay, now check
this
it out.
Is amazing.
Check it out. You got your onion rings, you got your sauce. Give me a knife so I can cut right down this son of a bitch.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a little hot. Let's see the temp. I might have overcooked it a little bit.
Mike, I gotta tell you, I don't think you overcooked it.
I might have overcooked it, so we're gonna go right down the middle. All right, let's
look at
the juice.
Pouring
let's
out
that.
Of
here we go. Oh, that medium rare color.
My God.
Oh boy. All right, what do you want to do?
I want to eat it.
We're going right in?
I think we should go right
look
in.
Look at the middle. Get in there. Look at the juices.
Look at this.
Look at that. It's like we're selling that pan.
Burger.
Not already.
The juice is going to shoot right
out of
my head.
Here
ready?
We go.
Okay. Onion rings are fantastic.
Not bad.
The burger's fantastic.
There you go.
Excellent, Mike.
Good stuff?
Good stuff, Bubby.
All right.
I think you forgot something, though. What did I forget?
The lettuce.
Oh, shit!
Hey, we always forget something.
Okay, right. You're making the flip. Jackie's making the flip. All righty, here we go. We are going to put these beautiful flankers on.
Yes, look at that.
What he doesn't know is that he's not going to be able to clean this grill ever again. He's going to have to sandblast it off.
I'd like to mention our sponsor, LMN Printing Company of New York, bringing you 45 years of digital printing, from business cards to posters, from graphics to website design, and a full line of advertising promotional materials. Located at 23 West Merrick Road, Valley Stream, New York, don't hesitate. Call today, 516-285-8526, or go to lnmprinting.com for all of your printing and advertising promotional needs.
So now
Now, yes. What do we do?
What do we do now?
We put them in the oven for 5 more minutes and let that dry up the sauce a little bit. All right. Go ahead. Do it, my friend.
You want to put it in, Smell?
I can't walk. Yeah. All right. Okay. This guy thinks I'm real. What an asshole. All right. He's talking to me. All right. Leave the guy alone. All right.
Hey. So where did you work? In Mookie's Pizza Shop?
I don't eat this shit. All right. Smokey. Yeah. Tell him what he's supposed to do. What do you tell him? What he's supposed to do? Give me all your money, motherfucker. All right.
Okay, so while we're waiting now for the English muffins to toast up, John's going to show us a little magic trick. Go ahead, John. What do you got?
I was just going to say, in between, I'll do something fun. So these are my cheap business cards. Yeah. They're very inexpensive cards. They're like one of those online, 1,000 cards for $1.99.
Yeah, you're going to have to go with our advertiser.
So they're all the same.
Right.
And then all the backs are the same.
Right.
So you're going to take one of my business cards, anyone that you like.
Oh, anyone at all.
Except that one. Please don't take that one.
Okay.
Do you like that one?
I do.
Okay. So what you're going to do is take...
Should I show the audience?
Yes.
Wait a minute. This is even better. Yeah.
So you're going to sign your name across the back of the card.
Okay.
And that's your name. Look how nice that is.
Isn't that perfect?
Yeah.
They don't do this in schools anymore.
Script is gone.
Script is over. It's done.
Actually, next time we do this, we try to do it with texting, right?
Yeah.
All right, so that's your name on the card.
Gotcha.
And you hold the card in your hand like so.
Okay.
And I'm going to take a card, any card, from my deck of cards.
Any card.
Any card. And I'm going to put my name on it. My name is not Larry, it's John.
Okay.
Like that. Right?
Okay.
What do I do with my card?
Well, you can put it in your hand.
I put it in my hand. Just like this.
Okay.
Fair?
Fair.
Now for the magic part. I snap my fingers and they actually change places. Watch this. It just happened. Did you see that happen?
Yeah, I felt it.
You did. Now the hard part is to make it go right back. All right, you don't believe me. Just believe me. All right.
This is true magic, folks.
It didn't go back. I left him.
Okay.
So if it really worked, that means that...
That means I should have John in my hand.
That means I have...
Whoa.
Wow.
All right, John, hold these two cans. All
right? you're the wrong persuasion for me to hold your cans. All right.
All right, so we have Rosie here.
Rosie, very congratulations.
You heard of Jenny from the Bronx? This is Rosie from the Bronx.
All right.
How many months?
This is my month, dude.
Huh? This is it?
Yes.
Good for you. You look good. You look good.
Month 15.
And who did that to you? That man over there? All right.
We'll be calling him names when that comes out. I'm sure.
I hope it all goes well. I'm sure it's going to go. Just a nice, nice, healthy child. All right. I'm going to do a quick card trick. Your name is? What's your name?
Rose.
Rose?
Yes.
That's my brother's name. Interesting. All right. So... So I have a deck of 52 cards.
It's a fun
cards.
Family.
and all the cards. She's going to, rather than choose a card, I don't know if people notice this, every card in the deck is different, but every card in the back is exactly the same.
Mm.
And what's on them, Rose?
What's on them?
Yeah, no one ever notices. What is it?
It's a person.
It's little angels inside of a circle, trapped, looking to get, one is a male, one is female, and they're looking to connect. And they can't because they're trapped within the circle.
Okay.
So the object of this is not, you don't have to pick a card, you're going to pick an angel. So anytime I go through this deck...
Is this a religious game?
No, not at all.
I don't want to be struck down the middle with my pizza crunching.
That's right, we're in the middle making pizza.
Oh my God, boom, the lightning hit.
Jesus, crust.
Yeah.
All right. So anytime I go through here, you'll say stop, and then that'll be the card that you chose.
Okay.
Doesn't matter what it is, just anytime you want, you just say stop.
Stop.
That's it.
Okay.
So that's it.
Was that a test or was that the real thing?
She's quick. She's fast. Quick. But that's the two of what? Spades.
Two of spades.
Okay, so you take the two of spades, sign your name right on it, which we know is Rose, just like my brother. And that becomes the Rose card, right? Okay. So it's the front is the two of spades. On the back, it's the male and female energetic angels.
Okay.
One is male, one's female. I want you, this is the male, I want you to rub it real hard. That makes him very happy. Larry.
Obviously.
And in fact, she did less of that. There wouldn't be that.
Exactly. She's a little more rubbing. There wouldn't be a big bump.
That's what I'm saying. You rub the female, Larry.
Pleasure.
And the way you do it, I could see why you're single.
Yeah.
Now, let me give it a big rub.
There you go. As a matter of fact, I could say you take matters in your own hands. For the way. All right, so there's the male and the female. Now they're excited. All right, they're excited. All right, so what happens? This, do you notice that her name is on the front, the angel's on the back, and this is a Black Mirror. They made a movie after this called on HBO, I think, called The Black Mirror, right? Mm-hmm. And if you hold this, it reflects the actual card in the Black Mirror. Mm-hmm. And that's what I'm going to ask you if you can see the reflection, is what I'll ask you, okay? Let's see if I can find this up so you can, how we can play this. How should we play this? Okay. Well, you could do it this way, I guess. Can you see the reflection in the mirror?
Mm.
Of it?
Yes.
Depends how you twist it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to turn on the phone and check it out. I'm going to take the card and go like this.
He's rubbing the mail.
I'm rubbing the mail, scratching him.
Ooh, that's an irritation. What?
What?
And he's gone. Feel
he's
this.
Gone.
Holy.
It's actually inside the phone floating.
And this that's is amazing.
But here's the creepy.
Dude.
The creepy part is
I'm gonna have a baby now.
The creepy part is the connection, because now it's floating freely and look.
Oh, it's right next to it.
This is freaking me out.
Together, forever, the way they're supposed to be, like you and that baby.
Oh.
Cherish that forever.
Yes.
You saw this on the Left with Larry Cooking with Comics show, folks.
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode of The Best Of as much as we enjoyed filming them. So stay tuned for episode 20 coming soon.